John 14, verse 6.
Jesus said to him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me.
What you need here is one thing. Life. That life is Jesus. Your business can collapse. But once it receives life, it will move. Your marriage can collapse. But once it receives life, it will move. Your career can collapse. But once it receives life, it will move. Once you have Jesus, you're already a billionaire. Because you'll be able to move. You'll be able to walk. You'll be able to work. And whatever you work, you'll be able to get the achievement. Somebody can have money and work and fail any achievement. You know that? And somebody says, I'm getting money, but I don't know where the money goes. I cannot register anything. I don't know, something wrong. I'm in the marriage, but I'm as if I'm not there. I don't know. I have no peace. I have no. Hallelujah. So Jesus Christ is the way to prosperity. He is the way to success. He is the way to peace, to freedom. And above all, is the way to heaven. Reverend, what is it? Where is your husband? Because this is the issue now.
My name is Reverend Joyce Mungai.
This is the issue you're asking God.
Yeah. I don't have a husband for the longest time. And I have, there were three husbands. I was married when I was very young. Then that man was into drugs and addiction with the heroin and cocaine. We separated. Then I got married to another man. Then the mother had so many problems with me. And then we separated to the chief.
And you got the small man.
Yes, the small man. I had him for the rest 8 years because he was very young. And then... Yes, there is. Yes, I prayed and God gave me this man, but I don't know what happened, man of God.
This mama.
Yes, because I went home to visit my mother, and I left my mother talking with this man. And from that day, that man has never talked to me, even to date. He left me to my grandfather's house, and I've been asking God. God, I prayed and I fasted. And God, you gave me this man. Where did this man left me just like that? He never talked. I tried to apologize every way that a woman can apologize. But this man just left like that. The third one. And this has been paining me day and night.
Small man, go and sit.
Clearance is going on for Reverend Joyce Mungai from Kenya.
Your mom spoke something to that small man. Because she was not happy the way the dowry issue was done.
Man of God, what you are saying is very true. Because that very day, that man left me, we were going to pay my mother's dowry. And my grandmother, even to date, she's not happy about that marriage. Because my mother was married, and then he left that man for 34 years. Then, after that, he went back to that man. And my grandmother always complains about that dowry.
And the priest who is talking to you just wants something from you, but... The way is...
there is a priest that talks to me, but now I don't talk to that priest because I felt that this man is not good. So, and he was asking me if he can exchange a woman, like he exchanged his woman and me. And I told him, let me tell you, you are chaplain and I'm a chaplain. So just live with your woman, leave me alone. What you say, man of God, is very true and nothing but truth.
The old man from US, what happened?
Oh, the old man that I have a picture here. Man of God, what you are saying about the old man that's from the US, I have this man here. He was trying to question me about my marital life, but I denied everything. Like, I did not tell him how I live and how I stay in my house. So this man just went quiet.
Majina yangu ni Patrick Adina.
My name's Patrick Abina.
Natoka Kenya.
I come from Kenya.
They brought a rope.
Yes.
Walileta kamba.
And they put it just in front of the house.
Na wakaeka hiyo kamba mbele ya nyumba.
Where they wanted the landmark.
Sababu hapo hiyo unaonyeshwa ndio walikuwa wanataka kuweka alama ya hiyo shamba.
But just in front of the house.
Lakini mbele tu ya nyumba.
Ukweli kabisa.
And they said, this land doesn't belong to you people.
Wakasema hii shamba si ya nyinyi watu.
You may stop there, not to exceed in the compound.
Mukome hapo, musimame hapo, musizidi.
And everybody got confused.
Na kila mtu akachanganikiwa. Akastuka.
Ever since that time,
kutoka hiyo wakati,
the whole family people have no peace.
Jamii yote hamna amani.
Mtumishi wa Mungu, yote ni ukweli.
What you're saying, man of God, all is true.
And this land still has a problem in front.
Na hii shamba ardhi bado iko na shida hapo mbele.
Ni ukweli kabisa mtumishi.
It is true, man of God.
Jirani huyu alijenga choo hapa miguu minne kutoka katika mahala makonge yalipokuwa.
Even where
yuko mbele yangu.
Even where I am
karibu na nyumba yangu.
Only 4 feet my neighbor built there, and that is where their sisal plantation.
Tumevurutana kotini saini.
We have been pulling ropes, wrangles for 4 years.
Tumewekwa kotini, hatusongi.
We have gone to court, but we are not progressing.
With this neighbor.
Na huyo jirani.
Na mishtaki mimi na wengine.
It is the neighbor who took me to court and also took others to court.
Why?
Kwa nini?
Kwa sababu ya hii ardhi.
Because of this land.
Hii kamba, wakati walipoileta,
when they brought this rope,
ilikuwa ni kamba ya makonge.
It was a rope made of sisal,
ambapo waliipitisha mchana peupe.
And they passed it across.
Na hapo ndio shida zangu zilianzia.
That is where my problems began.
Tangu wakati nilipoanza kujenga nyumba hii,
from the time I started building this house,
nikiwa na mke wangu ambaye tulipoanza kuingiza tu nyumba hii tukakosa amani.
Together with my wife, from that time we lost peace.
Hatukuweza kuishi naye hata wiki moja kwa nyumba hii.
After that we were not able to live with my wife in that house for 1 week.
Nimejaribu kuoa mabibi nikae nao kwa nyumba hii.
I have tried to marry wives to live in this house.
Lakini mwisho wa siku ni talaka.
But at the end of the day is disagreement.
Na hata niliye naye leo tuko naye kwa nyumba hii.
Even the wife I have now, whom I live in this house with,
wakati ninaporudi kutoka kazini sina amani na yeye, ni vita na ile kelele na ile kutofautiana.
When I come back home I have disagreements with my wife, we always argue and quarrel.
Hii ndio nyumba yangu ya kwanza.
This is my first house.
Hiyo nilipojenga tukiwa na baba. Baba alikuwa na hapa mbele yangu.
I built it and my father was in
hapo
front.
Hapo alipitisha mkamba na baba alikuwa anaishi hapa.
Where they passed the rope beyond is where my father was had his house.
Akanitolea new boma kidesturi yetu ya huko Bunyala.
So according
akaniweka huko chini.
According to our custom in Bunyala, my father gave me land beyond where he was staying.
So alipotoka,
when he left,
akanipatia hii ardhi yote.
He gave me this land.
Ndio nikaanza kujenga.
That is when I started building this house.
Hiyo wiki moja tulipokaa ndani,
1 week of staying there,
mambo yakaharibika.
Things went bad.
Baba na mababa zangu wengine hawasikizani.
My fathers and the brothers, they are not in agreement.
Na hata hii ardhi nimeishi ni ya babu.
Even this land where I live belongs to my grandfather.
Na hata mababa zangu wengine ambao wako nyuma yangu hawataki niishi pale.
And behind the house for my grandfather, the other brothers of my grandfather are living there and they don't want me to live in that compound.
Before you build in this place,
kabla ujenge sehemu hii,
you people found a strange stone.
Nyinyi watu mlipata mawe ambayo si ya kawaida.
Ndio.
And you removed the stone.
Na mkatoa hiyo mawe.
Jiwe ulilosema lilikuwa la wale wa mama zamani walikuwa wanashagia unga.
The stone you're talking about, man of God, is the one women used to grind flour.
Nyanyangu alikuwa anashagia unga, ndio nilipata pale ambapo nilikuwa ni jambo la kutamausha.
My grandmother used to use that stone to grind flour and that is the stone I removed.
Okay. And the stomach problem you've had?
Na shida ya tumbo uko nayo?
Ndio mtumishi wa Mungu hapa, ni ukweli.
Yes, man of God, it is true.
Niko na shida ya tumbo, niko na shida ya kifua.
I have a problem in my stomach, also
na
my chest.
Na hata huu mkono.
Even my
pia hand. Una shida tangu tu niingie kwa hii nyumba, mkono ina shida.
Ever since I entered that house, even my hand.
Reverend Kingon from Brother Patrick from Kenya.
Father, we command the spirit of killing, stealing, destruction, go. Father, give him the strength, the ability to overcome this issue in Jesus' holy name. Apo. There's a place where they are built shops and there is a plot there.
Kuna sehemu, kuna maduka na kuna shamba au plot hapo.
I've seen you acquiring that land and you have built 3 shops.
Nimeona ukichukua hiyo shamba iwe yako na umetengeneza duka 3.
Ndio mtumishi wa Mungu.
Yes, man of God.
Na hapo mahala ni niko na mpango wa kwenda kuchukua hiyo ardhi.
That place, I've been having a plan to go and get that land and buy it.
Na hayo maduka.
Even the shops.
These are the 3 shops.
He's on the duka 3.
Thank you, Jesus.
My name is Maria Banda. I come from Zambia. My question is...
Before you complain of this man, you should blame yourself.
Yes, very true. I confirm the prophecy. I've been going out with a married man and have 2 children with him. The spirit of limitation, stagnation. Ask Jesus Christ to forgive me for the salvation of my soul.
Be free in Jesus.
Reverend Skengon for Sister Maria Banda from Zambia.
A surprise.
My name is Marriage. Very
you flew as a bird. I've never seen such a marriage. Oh God.
Man of God, what you are saying is true. I'm in a marriage. Now this marriage, man of God, we quarrel every week. I don't have peace in my marriage. I don't know if that man was meant for
a
me.
A surprised marriage.
So I wanted to fly from the marriage, but before I did that, I decided to come here so that you help me to make a decision, man of God.
The Lord Jesus will give you a good answer.
Reverend Skengon for Sister Violet from Zambia.
My name is Elias Mlenga from Zambia.
A man who never respected women. When you stood up, 3 women stood up and said, this man never respected women. I said, hey, I don't know him. He said, this, he doesn't learn. Maybe he will learn this time. So what do you do with the women? Why don't you respect them?
Man of God, the marriage that I was in was so sophisticated. And we couldn't get along.
Are you talking about the brown woman?
The colored woman. We used to fight, man of God, every day.
I see a woman with the hair like
this. Yeah, with hair like this, yes. Actually, she's the one who's staying in my house that I built. The brown woman, we used to fight every day. And she's the one that you are saying as number three. I left the house for her to go and stay somewhere. I was staying in Luanshi. The first one was brought by my sister when I was at work. They just found that, no, there's a lady with pregnant for you. And that's how
the
she was forced.
One of the two kids?
Yes, the one with two kids. Then second one, we didn't have any child.
Have you learned a lesson?
I've learned a lesson.
And you give them false promises. The third one, you promised her a good business. Did you do that business for her?
I gave her the money, but she was not also genuine enough to manage the business.
You have given somebody a vehicle to drive. You two, you go in the same position and you sit. You drive. Why did you sit on her to drive? Why you didn't give her a chance to do her business, yet you promised her heaven and earth and had another man, the medium man?
That prophecy I confirm. There was a man who came, who approached me at my office to say, the woman that you are going out with is a woman I want to marry.
Learn to respect women.
Man of God, I'm asking for Jesus to forgive me.
She has given you another chance.
That is true, man of God, that I can confirm.
That's a touch for his deliverance. Mr. Elias from Zambia.
Father, we thank you. We bless your holy name. Go and say sorry to her.
My name is Andongo. I'm coming from Kenya, Prophet.
As you were rising up, the woman stood to fight you. What happened?
There is a certain woman where we are staying. He's short. He claims he comes from Uganda, but he comes from Busia. He's always in our gate, but he said he will fight me, and I'm chasing her from our gate. He's gossiping. Sometimes he wants to distract my boy when he's going to the shop. So I was annoyed, and I told him, what are you doing in my gate? You better go where you have rented the house. You are not our tenant. Why do you want? It is true, Papa. You are talking the truth. Oh, thank you. I'm happy. It is true.
Ever since this woman came into your compound,
true, Papa,
you have no peace.
I don't have peace.
You walk like a mad woman?
Yes, Papa.
Where's your husband?
My husband, I'm not married. I came with my sister. She's from US.
The Papa. Tall boy didn't marry you?
No, he didn't marry me.
But you remember him.
I know him.
That is where you confuse your life.
Man of God, what you are saying is true. That tall boy, I know him. But I didn't get married to him.
Because of the vehicle issue. So,
what man of God you are saying is true? I left the other boy. I came to that who had a vehicle so that I may be inside the car. I didn't see myself going on foot.
But things didn't work.
It didn't work, man of God. You're talking the truth.
You said, I'll not marry an old man.
Hey, I don't want an old man. Hey, I'm a young girl. What you are saying is true, Papa. Hey.
She's being delivered in Jesus' name.
In the name of Jesus, Father, I command the spirit of killing, stealing, destruction, go. In Jesus' holy name. Be free in Jesus' name. So you are the one from America?
Yes. My name is Felista. I'm from Texas. I'm originally from Kenya.
You two are not married. I see two kids.
I have two children, and it's with two different men. I'm divorced.
This is where you confuse yourself, and you got a very honorable man, and you started making your games.
Yes, man of God, what you're saying is true.
My name is Nkwasa. I come from Zambia. You have a son who troubles you.
Yes, man of God.
My name is Lillian Chuswe. I'm the sister to Morini.
Mm-hmm.
She's my elder sister.
Mm-hmm.
Man of God, what you are saying is true. She has a boy who troubles her a lot.
Is going on for them in Jesus' name.
This is Hidat. I came from Canada.
You people, you were three families.
We are three families.
And you're regretting meeting this man.
It is very true that he mentioned three family. I was married to a gentleman, a father of my two kids, but after the divorce, he married his friend. And then while he was married to me, he has another wife as well. He has twins children with her.
Father, remove the sorrow from heart. Give her peace. My hallelujah belong to you.
Majina yangu ni Margaret Musyoka.
My name is Margaret Musyoka.
Natoka Kenya.
From Kenya.
Niko hapa na mume wangu.
I'm here with my husband.
You have a man who attacks you in the dream.
Uko na mwanamume ambaye anakuvamia kwa ndoto.
Vile umesema ni kweli,
prophet. What you have said is true, prophet.
This is the man who is trying to destroy your marriage, your relationship.
Huu ndio mwanamume anataka kuangamiza ndoa yako na mahusiano yako.
Whenever you dream of that man,
wakati unaota kuhusu mwanamume,
you call the husband nonsense.
Unamuita bwana wako ni kama mtu hafai.
Tumishi wa Mungu ni kweli unavyosema.
Man of God, what you said is true.
Huyu ndio mume wangu.
This is my husband.
Na vile umesema ndio huwa namfanyia.
What you have said is what I do to my husband.
Katika ndoto, mi huona mtu analala na mimi kimwili.
I normally see a man sleeping with me sexually in the dream.
Be set free in Jesus' holy name.
Lady Margaret from Kenya receiving deliverance together with her husband. In Jesus' name.
This is the only problem you people have.
Hii ndio shida tu pekee nyinyi watu mko nayo.
Even finances. Whenever you see that man in the dream,
wakati unaona yule mwanamume kwa ndoto,
whatever you are doing,
chochote
chochote na man of God, what you say is true.
So let's remove that man.
Wacha tutoe huyo mwanamume.
Everything will be okay.
Kila kitu itakuwa sawa.
In Jesus.
Kwa jina la Yesu.
My name is George Jamongo. I'm from Kenya.
The woman you say never step into my home. She went to report you to heaven.
Never.
Man of God, the woman who you have just shot, she tried to force herself to my house, and I told her not to step in the house because I was already married, and I think she was looking for me to be my wife.
Ever since that time, you have no peace.
I have no peace, ma'am. And things which I do, they don't work out.
What you need now is just peace. And the issue of the stone quarry, the business of the stone quarry, we are now reviving it. You get a lot of money. What happened? You would have been a very rich man through the stone quarry.
I went to another business, Clear and Forty. The stone quarry, I found it was hard for me to do it. So I left it out. So I just
went. And this is the business God had given you. The rock is only 5 miles from your place.
Yes, it's about around there, yes.
The people want the stone and work.
My name is Gideon Aliero from Kenya. Man of God, I have just one question on our family. Being the firstborn in the family of 14, no one has prospered.
You have two pastors.
Yes, man of God.
And they want a land. This is a problem. Hey, I warn you, they will never leave that land.
I confirm
children
the prophet.
Children to children. What the Lord has showed to me, they will forge documents until when they take that land, your children will never like it.
That's what is happening in our family. I confirm the prophet. It's true. My father is a pastor for many years. But the issue of the land is very great in our family. Even I have my younger brother here. He can confirm the two pastors, one is from their church. There was a wrangle between the lands. So they decided to change that land. The one that my father has donated to the church came back.
My names are Patrick Aliero from Kenya. Man of God, what my elder brother is saying, I confess, it is true. We have got two churches in our father's land. One being father donated to the Salvation Army Church. And later on, when the father left Salvation Army Church, joined the Miracle Revival Church, situated in Mombasa, and also decided to give another piece of land. And from there, we have been having problems. Although I had remained in the Salvation Army Church, where my father was formerly, and part of us are still there in that part of church, and some of us also have joined where the father is.
Until when the father does something, that land, even this place in between, where there's a small house, after the death of your father, they have claimed the whole land up to the valley.
Yes, the land there with a small house is there, still hanging like that.
I'm so sorry that the land has been taken by pastors. They have left the family with no land at all.
Reverence is going on for the two brothers.
Belongs to you. Tell us about the mechanical man.
My name is Abigail Bunga. I come from Zimbabwe. The prophecy is true about the mechanic guy. I met that guy online dating. Then he wanted to sleep with me. I refused. Then he dumped me.
That is why I asked you, where is the mechanic man? Okay, you don't have a husband.
I don't have.
No problem. Come, gentlemen.
Man of God, the prophecy is true. He looks like my ex-husband.
So long as you are teaching men lessons, it will not go well with you. Stop teaching men lessons.
I want forgiveness, man of God.
Be a good woman. You are still young by the blood of Jesus. Father, she's your daughter. Have mercy upon her.
My name is Nicholas. I'm a Kenyan but residing in Mozambique.
You people must stop here. I say. You people once upon a time had an issue concerning the land. There were three parties, two major ones and the one. So there was a very big trouble, and the old man said, never step this, never step here.
I can confirm, because where we stay, the land of my father, he was staying there, but he had not paid that land. But it came to a time when he needed the person who had given the land to sell to him. But during that time of selling, one of the neighbor was trying to be a bit clever. He told my father, because my father did have money at that time, he wanted to give my father money and to buy that land and give my father some time, and after some years to leave the land. My mother refused, and they started buying slowly.
So let me pray for you.
Pastor Nicholas, receiving deliverance.
For the blood of Jesus.
My name is Onim Tinta Kazemba. I come from Zambia.
Once you were a beloved daughter, and you were to become a doctor.
That was my dream, but I didn't go there because my mother didn't have finances then to take me to school.
May Jesus open your way.
George and Sean.
I thought they were two, but I could see three.
Ana pasala, this is Father. Ana beta menjuru Sudan.
Yeah, he says he's from South Sudan. His name is Jur John Shaw.
نسوان ثلاثة مشاكل مزاد بيجا كتير حتى دخلني مع أخواتي في مشاكل أخواتي زاد نسوا يعني بدقت بقصادهم.
He has a lot of problems. Three wives. He got
this is the problem he has. The three wives. Because he cannot even manage them. Even now the back has started paining him.
He said, yes, prophet, I have a back problem. And he said, what is it, man of God, is true.
He said, yes, I'm asking God to forgive me.
Yeah, probably.
Let me pray for you.
I can't to forgive.
The Lord will help you.
The brother from Sudan being delivered.
Ana tamam maaf ya haya. Raslapo dharya se hasibo fi u wala mat al batn zada.
He said he feel good.
Hasibo.
So you feel good.
Thank you, Jesus, for healing him. He's now fit.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Father. I love you, Father. I love you, God. All of them, I love you.
Oh, my God.
Thank you, Jesus.
People, things are not moving on well. When I pass, you ask me about the marriage. Pastor, talk about our marriage.
Yes. My name is Molly. I'm from Zimbabwe, but I reside in New Zealand. And beside me is my husband. Well, I confirm your prophecy to be true men of God. There've been a lot of problems in our marriage, a lot of arguments and disagreements. And we haven't been living like a happy marriage.
My name is Julius Ndondo. I am a Zimbabwean and I live in New Zealand. I want to confirm the prophecy, man of God. We have been having strong arguments recently.
Why do you compare her with the white ladies? This woman has been a helping hand in your life.
Man of God, I confirm the prophecy to be true. I always blame my wife and compare with what I see the white ladies do sometimes to their husbands. I ask Jesus Christ to forgive me for the salvation of my soul. Thank you,
Lord. The moment you stop comparing her with the white, everything is going to be okay. Mama, we have defeated him. The enemy has threatened your life three times, and this you could see it in the dream. The spirit of death is walking with you.
My name is Chongonye Mbadokas from Zambia. I would love to confirm what the man of God said about death issue, like three times. I think 3 weeks ago, a month ago, I had a dream where, like, I died, I went to this room where there were white, like white curtains. And I went somewhere very dark and I was crying to say, I don't want to die now. Then I heard a voice saying, go back. No, not this one. So I was saying, that's Jesus Christ who has saved me. And I was telling my cousin back in Zambia to say, this is the dream I had. I don't know if I'm dying or it's something. So she was laughing at me to say, no, I think they're just one of those dreams. So I confirmed. Also, the second one, I dreamt I was dead. The third one, I also dreamt of the same, but I can't just clearly remember what really happened. So what the man of God said is true.
Father, we remove this premature death in Christ Jesus' holy name. So whatever is required of you, the Lord has done it for you.